open the results, import the libraries, change change directory, sorry, the first part is useless. Use the second one, but okay. As always, set the name of the CSV file, treat it with pandas data frame. My suggestion, instead of display the data frame like this, with EF SW, use head command, because otherwise will display the all, more or less all the time series, so it's quite huge. Okay, in this case you have the date in this column, but it's a string. Okay, so now we want to change this type of string in a datetime object for Python. So in this case, Python can recognize the type of date. And in this case, I rename the column, the first column, as datetime. This command to change the datetime column into a datetime object and set the index of the data frame. In this case, the index is this, it's just numeric, with the field datetime. Okay? So in this case, okay, please come back to this cell, okay, and open again the data frame and rename the first column as datetime, because now I want to add this. Okay, please copy this after the head command and put the yellow sticky note when you
tutor.
Copy this in your notebook, please. This one. Do you copy that? Okay. So I'm sorry, but I forgot to insert this command in this dot not. Why we are doing this? Because I want to rename all the other column with a number instead of a name. Okay. We need to reload the data frame, okay? Because before we load the data frame, then we do some operation, and then we can rename it, okay? Now all the columns are renamed with a number. In this case, the number is equal to the ID of the station. Okay. As before, we said the daytime column as a daytime object, and then equal to the index, okay? And then we want to extract from the data frame all the row and all the column starting from the second one, okay? We cut out format and daytime. Okay. This is why I use head, because otherwise you have a lot of value. Sorry. Okay. If I want to plot all the data frame or a single column, I can plot this. If I want to plot all the data frame, sorry, just write df.plot. If you want to plot single column, insert iloc in the number of the column. Okay. And this is the shortwave radiation for a Fourier. These are some numeric error due to the component, but I don't know how to fix it. This is the result for Fourier, okay? But in this case, we are not keeping in consideration the cloud effect. So this is the, let's say, theoretical shortwave radiation, okay? So what we need to do is to compare the shortwave theoretical radiation evaluated in this way with the shortwave radiation collected by a meteorological station. And for doing this, we can use the clearness index. Here the link to the documentation. Also in this case, the clearness index is, from the theoretical point of view, a number include between 0 and 1, because is the attenuation of the shortwave radiation. Here you can find, as usual, the description of the input and of the output of the component. Okay. So this is the same file. As usual, change the start and the end date. In input, you have the shortwave radiation as read at the station, and the one at the top of the atmosphere computed by the previous component. I don't know if you have some radiation in the data folder. Okay, load the radiation, this file, on OSF in exercise, so you can download in a minute.
What we're doing here is comparing the value.
We are comparing the radiation at the top of the atmosphere.
That is the one you calculated before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With the one measured at the station.
Okay.
But essentially now you don't have.
Yeah, because first before we did it in the central, it's not in the station.
Yeah, but I mean, you have the radiation evaluated by the component, but you don't have the shortwave radiation collected by the station.
Yeah.
Okay. So I give you some.
Okay.
Download this file and put it in data or where you want. Shortwave dot sim. Is in the edition folder.
Are the same?
Yeah, the same. Move the radiation CSV in the folder data, okay? Change the start and end date equal to the start and end date of your simulation, shortwave simulation, okay? Change the path and the name and put it in the shortwave top of atmosphere of your component, the one you obtained before. Maybe the path and the name is the same, I don't know. Set the output path and the name as you want. I don't care. here at the moment. Okay. Then only for the Docker user, use this command. Okay. The other use the console. Okay, let's try.
Can you go up and?
Yeah, sure. If you have. Okay, try if you have any error is coding. My mistake. This is not the shortwave.sim, but is clearness index.sim. Sorry. Okay. So you have only to update the path and the name. Start and then date, and I guess everything should work.
La data start and then date non è la stessa della prima simulazione, giusto?
Is it right that it is very, very fast?
Yeah.
E quindi è un uguale
e soprattutto è in data slash CSV, quindi è un computer CSV.
Ah, ok, abbiamo cercato di dirmi uno scusi.
Prova, dovrebbe andare.
Remember that in a same file you have to change only three fields, start and then date, name and path of input and of out of the output files and the ID. Stop, nothing else. the 90% of the errors we will have are bounded to this grid. Okay? Sorry? Okay. Okay. Does it work? Okay, so let's plot the result. So change directory.
Sorry. Is it okay? It says missing data frustration one, missing data frustration two.
Sorry.
Number of warnings.
Okay. for sure we will have a lot of minus 999 or not a number, because there are very few values in the radiation shortwave CSU. So in order to plot the result, as before, rename all the column, rename the first one as the time. Okay. And with this command, I will replace all the minus 999 with not a number. Okay? Here I start a single station, compute the mean, just and this is the plot, so from the theoretical point of view the clearness index shall be a value between 0 and 1. But it is not the case. This could be due to the fact that we have a lot of diffuse radiation, essentially, and so the azo radiation is bigger than the predicted. Okay. Obviously, only in this case, okay?
So we should obtain a range of values between 0 and 1, right? Or no?
Yeah, but if you plot it at the E scale, you see that there's an error at the in the evening, let's say at the sunshine, because the radiation at the top of the atmosphere shall near to zero, but you have radiation at your station due to the shortwave diffuse radiation, so not from the direct one. Okay? And if you want to plot for the result, at the end, I try also the shortwave radiation raster. I saw that it's not much time consuming, so we can try it. Always input raster IO. Now I plot the DTM. Okay, this is my DTM, but it is for sure too big. So I try this component on a smaller basin, on a smaller DTM. I don't know if you have a smaller one. Okay, maybe not now, but this evening or when you want, you can try on the Meledro basin. Maybe you can cut a piece of the basin, or you can downgrade the resolution. Okay. So I will show you my result. Don't try this because you don't have this data. So this is the temperature raster obtained with the creaking raster simulation. Okay. because after I calculated, I saw that that there is a station with all the value equal to zero, so this is an error. And okay. Okay. This is the rendition raster. And if we can see the DTM, maybe it's not so obvious. Okay. So we have less radiation on the side of the DTM that is the north base, essentially. Okay, because it's a shadow. And okay, stop. Okay. Okay. The long wave notebook is similar to the other. Always the link to the documentation. Here are some theoretical formulas that Riccardo told you this morning. This is the model description. Okay. You can, if you run this cell, you can load this table, because I forgot to upload the SF folder, but you can't find it in the documentation. Okay. Is exactly the same, just copy and paste. Okay. So load the library as usual. For sure, you will get an error because. There is no image in the folder. Okay. The input of this component are the clearness index time series. If you edit the time series, the master map of the relative humidity, the time series or raster map of high temperature. The soil temperature and the sky view factor. Okay? The sky view factor is always a raster. And these are the input. This show are parameter, so the number of the model and the parameter of the model, the number of the model are this, and these are the parameter. Okay, this parameter are fixed for each model, are taken from the papers. This is the range of emissivity of same simulation. The structure is the same of each other. Change the date if you want. Okay. In input, there is the air temperature as time series, the relative humidity. We don't have the soil temperature. So as default, the soil temperature, if it's not specified, is taken equal to the air temperature. Okay. The clearness index time series. The Skyview Factor raster map and the shape file of centroids, and then the x and y parameters of the model and the number of the model. Then the emissivity, we take 0.98 because it's more or less the mean value, and the A and B plot is taken equal to 0 to 1. If you want, you can change it. These are the four parameters. Okay. Obviously, if you are using the model number 6, change the name with the model 6. And okay. Then when you have finished, run it. Use the Docker command if you are a Docker user. Otherwise, you use the console. And put the yellow sticky note when you finish. If you have in okay, if you have there something different, you can update the path and the name with output caging and this file. I guess everybody of you will have this data in the folder.
don't have the humidity, do we have also
connected?
Yeah, but also the connect down or the only parameter?
Yes, also the connection. Okay. Like this. Sorry, not the airness index, the relative humidity. Okay. And if you don't have also the clearness index, you can comment also the clearness index. Olivia, if you want to comment all lines,
mm-hmm.
use the slash,
mm-hmm.
star, and at the end it will be the same. For everybody. Check the ID field, not only for the shapefile, but also for the air temperature. So, go in the folder. Okay, the ID is ID, not val, not something else. So add in this way. So you have to check only three fields, the start and the end date, the ID field, and the input name, file name, and path. Okay? Three fields to check always. Okay.
Yeah, there already is, okay, there already is, now if I can find the button.
Okay. location.
Yes.
As always, set the name of the data frame. Create the data frame. Replace the -9999 with run. Rename the first, not the first, the second column with daytime. Okay. Rename all the other columns with the ID number. Okay. This way. Set the daytime as index and cut the first two columns and plot, for example, the first column for the word data frame, as you prefer. Try to run again the simulation, but change the model.
Mm-hmm.
So use a different model. For example, I use the number 5, I guess. Yeah, the number 5. And try to run it and plot the difference. Okay? So open the last notebook. Last notebook is the one on the thread. application. Okay. Here the link to the documentation. As usual, import the library. The net radiation simulation taking input the shortwave radiation and the long wave downwelling and upwelling. Because the net radiation compute essentially the net radiation for the incoming radiation minus outgoing. Okay. Update the start and end date equal to the one you used for the shortwave, otherwise it doesn't work. For 1 year or 6 months.
Okay.